This is Judy from Los Angeles. Today we are going to talk about a different series. And the one we are going to talk about is the cities in Africa. My friends in the Americas, I just want to let you know that Africa is not all bush. Africa is upcoming with beautiful, beautiful cities. And you know what? Yes, Africans don't walk in the cities with lions, and they don't walk with wild animals. Trust me, Simba will eat you up. So we're going to talk about Nairobi City. And Nairobi is the capital of Kenya. The country is called Kenya. And Nairobi is the city capital of Kenya. And it is situated in south central part of the country in the highlands at an elevation of about 5,500 feet above sea level, which is 180 meters. The city lies 300 miles, that is 480 kilometers northwest of Mombasa, which is a major port off of the Indian Ocean. You guys, we will do Mombasa. Mombasa is a beautiful oceanfront city, and Mombasa has white sands. Those are immaculate, beautiful cities in Africa that I want to introduce you to, because at the end, one of these fine days, I'm going to take a group of people to come with me in a journey to Kenya to visit all these cities. And no, that is not just saying what it is. It is indeed very beautiful. Nairobi is a government center of Kenya. If I have to compare with Los Angeles, Sacramento is the capital of California, as Nairobi is the capital of Kenya. So it's a government city. Now, the word Nairobi means the land of cold waters, which is a Maasai word. It means the land of cold waters. The other myth, I want to just take it out. Not all Africa is a desert. Nairobi gets really cold, and Nairobi rains. The rains do come, and it's very green. And unlike Los Angeles, which is actually a desert, Nairobi is more wet, and it has cold, cool waters. That's why it's called Nairobi. As a government center, Nairobi subsequently attracts a stream of migrants from the rural parts of Kenya seeking for work and business opportunities. As you know, In many countries, the government is normally the biggest employer, and the government is headquartered in Nairobi. Therefore, you have everybody coming from the rural areas migrating into Nairobi for work, for business, for everything, because it's the capital city and it attracts everything there. So if you're looking for high-level jobs, you want to definitely go to Nairobi to get those high jobs. Nairobi is the principal industrial center of the country, that is the country of Kenya. Nairobi offers some beautiful getaways from the busy city life, Uhuru Park, which is also known as Nairobi Central Park, is a vibrant park that echoes the city's old slogan, the Green City in the Sun. If you have heard of the Green City in the Sun, that is Uhuru Park. Nairobi residents, tourists, students, business people from all walks of life visit the park every day for picnics, study, rest, and a host of other activities. The Serene Park is a place to take a breath, read a book, or catch up with family and friends. Nairobi also plays an important role in the community of Eastern African states. It is headquarters of important regional railways, harbors, and airways corporation. When you land into Nairobi, you're going to land into Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. And most of the big jets land in Jomo Kenyatta. And if you're going to the smaller cities, then you can take a local smaller flight that will take you inland, further out. But Nairobi will offer you the big cities. Among the city's architectural landmarks are the Kenyatta International Conference Center, the Parliament Building and City Hall, the Law Courts, the Roman Catholic Church. As you can see, Catholics really played a big role in Africa, and they have landmarks all over across Africa. And that's where one of them is the Roman Catholic Cathedral. This is a very youth cathedral in Nairobi, as well as we also have the Jamia Mosque in Nairobi, which is also in Nairobi, because we have both the Muslim and the Christian communities there. Nairobi is also a well-planned commercial center, but I think initially when they planned it, they did not anticipate the big numbers of migrants coming into the city. So it was quite well planned. But now when you go downtown, it's congested and the parking space is limited as more people have migrated into the city looking for work. So you see a lot of bodies. I'm in Los Angeles, and Los Angeles is spread out. So the closest city I can describe Nairobi is New York. I took my family down to New York one day, and it's so congested. For me, it reminded me of Nairobi. I know my husband didn't like it that much because of congestion. But if you like the fast-paced city life and a lot of people, human traffic, you will get that in Nairobi, all right? You will get that in Nairobi. Nairobi is also home to several educational institutions, including the University of Nairobi, Kenyatta University, and those are the big major government universities. But there are many, many, many more private universities and other institutions, which include the Kenya National Archives, the National Museum of Kenya, a very historic place, the Macmillan Memorial Library, and the Kenya National Theatre. Nairobi also has different excitements like the park, the game reserves, and that I will take you through that trip on my next series. So join me next time as we take you through our series of cities in Africa. And this is Minage, ATLE TV, Los Angeles. Thank you, and subscribe and follow us. Actually follow us as you get to know the big cities in Africa. And yes, Africa is growing, and no, Africans don't walk with lions in their hands. Trust me, Simba is a wild animal and it will eat your life if you do that. Thank you for following us. Thank you for watching us. Until next time, Minagi.